Hi, everyone. Welcome to Rob's Roundup from the Sloop Brewing Company Beer Balcony. I'm Rob Adams, joined by Renegades outfielder Brandon Lockridge. Brandon, how are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Good. Good to see you. Been swinging the bat well. How you feeling at the plate?
It's been a little bit of an adjustment coming back after a month off, but it's good to be back on the field.
Well, you're back out on the field and a crazy night last night here. Let's go through that. What was it like down there on the field? Because when Wilmington takes that lead, I'm up in the booth thinking, well, okay, three outs left, and okay. You guys, three outs meant a lot of baseball to be played. Take me through that inning, bottom of the 11th.
So starting out in the sixth inning, we were kind of, you know, anytime we're playing a fast-paced game, we're all like, oh, we're going to get out of here pretty quick tonight, you know, had a nice little lead and some things unraveled a little bit. But, you know, that big inning when they blew it open, it's a little frustrating, you know, after we've been playing really well, really good baseball from our pitching, swinging the bats well, defense, you name it. So you get down that little bit of a lead and, you know, it's tough to stay positive at times. But when you have an offense like we have and, you know, guys battle every single time they're in the box. So being able to piece together good at-bats, a few walks, some singles here and there, just passing the baton off to the next guy, it was incredible to see, you know, being able to see Duran come home to win the game after, you know, they walk done, Siegler come up with a huge double. It's awesome. It's a fun team to play with.
Definitely is fun. It's got to be. And yet, you know, you guys had some opportunities, couldn't quite bring home runs in some key spots, and yet there you are getting all those runs, all those hits in that spot. I know just from observing it, it was a lot of fun to watch. It's got to be fun to be a part of it.
It was awesome. Yeah, I mean, there's some situations where we came up, you know, it was unfortunate to not be able to get the run in a few situations, but, I mean, we're not out till, you know, the game's not over till the last out's made. So it was great to see our guys battle back like that.
Now you've got tonight off. What, from a mindset, I know you're supporting your teammates, but you want to play, I'm sure, you know, and you want to be out there. Let's be honest, right?
Of course. Yeah. I mean, off days are just part of it, you know, coming back after an injury, you're more susceptible to re-injuring after a bit of time off. So I understand not being able to play every night, but I mean, we got so many good players. Everybody on that bench could play every single night. So it's, I mean, getting guys chances to play, you know, just be able to sit down and relax and watch a game, you know.
We always try to talk to players about things that we might not know about them, something you can tell everybody here in the stadium that, you know, a fun factor or a hobby or something. What would it be with you?
Being from Florida, I'm a big fisherman. So this last year it was obviously unfortunate not getting to play baseball, but I was able to catch up on a lot of fishing in the summer that I don't normally get to do. So that was, fishing in the Gulf of Mexico with your buddies, it doesn't get much better than that. So that's one of my favorite hobbies in the summer.
What part of Florida is that?
So the Panhandle of Florida, up near Alabama,
sure.
Louisiana, all that. So it's a little bit warmer there right now. So, you know, talking to my buddies back home, I'm like, can't beat this baseball weather up here right now. So,
how are you enjoying the Hudson Valley?
It's great, beautiful country up here. A different, you know, I have family in upstate New York up on Lake Ontario, but this is my first time in the Hudson Valley, and it's been a great experience so far.
What have you liked about it?
The weather is number one thing. Played in Charleston in 2019, and the humidity, heat, everything. I mean, you know, getting down the 40s, 50s at night is amazing baseball weather. Pretty nice golf courses up here in rolling hills of Hudson Valley. But, yeah, everything, no complaints so far.
It's amazing the number of people, not just players, but coaches, Matt, and, of course, Fio as well. You all talk about golf. It's so great.
So many baseball players love golf.
Yeah.
I'm awful at golf, but it's, you know, something you get outside. It's kind of a relaxing thing. And, I mean, one day when I'm done playing, I'm hoping I'll be able to focus a little more on my golf swing and not as much my baseball swing.
Tell us a little more about being from Florida, the part of Florida you're from, and, you know, kind of explain that to folks.
So Pensacola, Florida, it's probably 30 minutes from the Alabama line. Mm-hmm. So I'm a big outdoorsman, so I enjoy bow hunting and stuff. So it's, you go a little north, you can bow hunt. You go a little south, you get to the salt water. So, I mean, it's a great location. It was a great place to grow up. Great baseball, played through the state of Florida, went to a state championship my sophomore year of high school. I mean, it was just a great place to grow up.
Sounds like a great place to grow up. Sounds like a great time here in the Hudson Valley as well. And keep having fun out in the field, and great to meet you for a couple of minutes. Thanks for your time.
Of course. Thanks for having me.
Brandon Lockridge joining us on Rob's Roundup. enjoy the game tonight. See if the Renegades can keep things rolling against the Wilmington Blue Rocks. I'm Rob Adams. This has been Rob's Roundup.